All right, we're back with part two on the 1970s Hustler amphibious vehicle, kind of like the Argo. If you guys missed last video, go check it out. We picked this thing up for $800. We got it running pretty good. This thing's got the Articat 400 engine in it with the Walbro carb. That carb we had to rebuild last video completely and get that thing working. So finicky, pain in the butt. But we actually got it running and pretty consistently. So we also fixed the electric start last video. The starter needed to be taken out, which meant the whole engine needed to come out of the machine last video. And we fixed the starter that wasn't rotating the engine over. So we fixed that as well. So we have not taken this thing for the first ride yet. I don't even know if it moves. Supposedly the guy before me had it moving and driving at one point, but you know, I don't know. So today we are going to attempt to get this thing to drive. A couple things we gotta do. We gotta add a return line from the carb. This carb has an intake line right here. Then it's got the excess fuel line, the return line going back to the tank, which we don't have. We were just using a temporary tank right over here and gas was just filling up the temporary tank. We wanted to go back into the tank and do a full revolution like that so that we don't waste gas. We gotta do that. We have to get a battery in here for the electric start. Last video we were just jumping this thing with a battery pack and yeah, to drive it, obviously we need a battery. And then we need to do wiring for the lights. Last video we attempted to get the lights working, but they weren't working. So today we're gonna tackle that as well. It has back lights right here and front headlights. We also have to button everything up and try and make this thing as waterproof as possible before taking it for the first ride. But we went to O'Reilly's, got a brand new battery for it. We got 12 foot of fuel line, little nipple for the gas tank that we have to thread in there for the return line. Some wire, some clip, some miscellaneous stuff we'll need to do the wiring for the lights. So I think we're gonna be all good to go. Vinny is checking it out. He's excited. I think he wants to take a ride in it when it's done, but I don't think he wants to work on it. He's like, way too much work for me. Vinny, what do you think? He's like, I'm out of here. You like it? What do you think, buddy? What do you think? What do you think? He's like, quit talking and do the video. So, all right, let's jump into the video and attempt to get this thing to ride today. Hopefully it moves. All right, let's tackle the fuel line first. It's probably gonna be the hardest thing to do. So we get the fuel line coming out of the carburetor right there. The intake to the carb for the fuel is right in the middle. And this one is the leftover gas. And we want this to go back to the gas tank. So I think we're gonna follow the line going back here and go right into probably over here. So it kind of curves around and comes right over here. Or we could go right in the front with it right here. I'm not sure what is the best option for that. So the fuel shutoff will be right there. We're gonna then run the line all the way back. So get a clamp on here. On. Attach the other line. There's actually a second pump in the carburetor that pumps the excess fuel out of the carb and back to the fuel tank. So you don't need to add a secondary pump to the system because it already pumps itself, which is kind of nice. So there's two pumps in the carburetor, which is kind of unique actually. Now we'll run this line all the way back to the tank. See how much line we have left over. And we'll probably secure this line right to the wires over here. So what we have to do is drill a hole, probably like right here. You want it towards the top of the tank because you want it to be feeding in gas. If you put it right here and there's gas already in the tank, it's gonna have a hard time pushing through that fuel that's already in the tank to let the excess fuel through. So we wanna go kind of to the top of the tank. And we've got the nipple right here. So we have to find out what size hole we need to make, and we'll just make a small one right there. All right, we're gonna go close to the edge and to the top. So probably like right here, I'm thinking. All right, now we have to find a tool that can put some threads in there. It won't be much of threads because it's so thin, but at least it'll be something. And then what we can do is just put a little O-ring gasket and that'll be good enough. All right, so the thread size on this fitting is M. So it's M10 by 1. That's the threads on here. So we need to take this and just thread that hole. Check that out. Awesome. All right, so we can twist that all the way in. And we'll get a little O-ring on there as well. Perfect. All right, that's looking good, nice and tight. All right, that'll attach with that. Our clamp here. Looks good. Actually, just tuck that kind of down like that. All right, we've got the return line fitted. Looking good. Everything's nice and tight. All right, let's try to tackle this wiring. So first, I want to add an inline fuse. This is the positive wire coming into the machine. And we want the fuse to burn out before the whole rest of the wiring harness does. So we'll add an inline fuse, and that'll prevent us from burning out the wiring if something goes wrong. Like that. So right now, we've got a 20 amp fuse in there. You can see. Put that back in. Then we'll just connect this in. And that's gonna be good to go. All right, so now we've got the inline fuse. We want the headlights to work. So one of these switches is for the headlights. If we go back to here, just see where the white is. It looks like white is right here. There's a red wire right here. There's a brown wire right here. So I believe, looks like a brown wire is right there too. I believe these are going to be negative. Positive, and then we've got the two negative wires over here. Two negatives here. My wrench accidentally hit that. Let's see if this thing cranks over now with the battery. Probably blew the fuse. Nope. So she cranks over. That's good. All right, next, we've got to figure out the lights. Let's see here. These alligator clips are good for testing purposes. Let's see, are we gonna get sparks? Nothing yet. Let's see if we... Nothing. The brown wire coming from the harness was actually negative. And the blue and the brown, or greenish blue, is feeding positive. The brown is feeding negative to the lights. So check this out. We got one light working. I think this one is burnt out. I think the gas tank was laying on it right here and it shorted out. So I think that bulb is burnt out right here. This one seems to be good. So yeah, that one's definitely working. This one is definitely not working. But we've got one light working. On the back here, we've got two lights we need to wire in as well. One's just a ground and one's a positive. So we need to tap into a positive wire here to control the lights in the back. All right, we got the lights wired up here, and those are gonna plug into this wire right here and this wire right here once we install the top. And when I click the key to on, those lights should turn on. We'll see. But let's get this battery secured down next. And I think that's pretty much all we have left to do. I want to quick lube up the chains as well. So let's do that next. I think we're good to go. We'll get the battery secured and then try to get this top back on this machine. All right, we got the covering back on here. Gas tank is all bolted up. Ignition is on and working. Let's see if the taillights work. We got them all hooked up now. So when we turn the key on, it should light up. Oh yeah. Hee hee hee. All right, lights are working. Awesome. All right, now we just have to get the choke working. So the choke is controlled by the wire right here, but there's nothing to hold that wire in place. So when you pull it, it obviously doesn't pull the choke back, it just pulls the whole cable back. So we gotta come up with a way to get the cable mounted back there so it pulls and pushes. All right, so what we did was just put a clamp right there holding that wire. Check this out. Pulls the choke up, lets it in, lets it out. So that's as good as that's gonna get. So I think this thing is pretty much done. We just have to go around and get the bolts in the side. So let's do that next. All right, you can kind of see there's a gap right here and you need to lift that plastic up into there to get the bolt in. What we're using is just a clamp. Squeezes that nice and tight and you can get your bolt in. So that's how we do that. We're gonna go around the whole thing and do that. We're not gonna put every single one in just in case we have to take this thing back off, but it is definitely a pain to get these on. All right, the top is secured down. I guess without further ado, let's see if she moves. Turn this thing on. That. Put a little spray in the carburetor. Okay. Let's see if she fires up. We'll do the choke. Wants to go. just idling a little high. Let's see if I can get that idle to get dropped down a little bit. Doesn't seem like it wants to go in reverse here. I don't know if the idle was too high to get it in reverse, but we'll try that. We'll start it up in reverse. That way, the idle's not too high. So reverse works, it's just hard to get in reverse. I think the idle is just a little bit too high. This thing actually flies pretty good once you get it to idle good. Oh geez, the battery fell. Ooh, that's not good. Ooh, that's really bad. Okay, let's get that fixed. Alright, so a couple things we need. The battery fell off. I had zip ties holding it on. So we need to secure that better. You can see it just melted that. I think the clutch did. Ooh, that's not too good. And then that's melted into the plastic right there, the exhaust. So we need to put that shield on there. Totally forgot about that. But otherwise, this thing's running pretty good. Not bad. Not too bad. All right, we got the heat shield on right here. It's all good to go. Battery is back on. Nice and tight in there. We put a strap around it with a wire right here. And that's not moving at all. All right, everything should be fixed right now.
Thank you. This thing is wild. But I can't even get my feet in here. Like, where are you supposed to put your foot? Should we take her on the road? Deep snow too. This thing's way faster than the other one. Way faster.
Well, first ride on the Hustler went pretty good. Not too bad. Obviously the carburetor could be tuned a little bit better, but it was revving out completely, and this thing was actually going pretty good. Kind of scary fast, actually. going down the road there. When you have six wheels, it's almost too fast. So this thing is pretty much set to go now. Basically all we have to do now is just tune the carburetor and get it to idle nice and low so I can pull it in reverse if I have to. Because right now it's just idling really high, and if you turn on the idle, it'll shut off the machine. So right now it wants to idle really, really high. Which, I mean, it could be the seals in the engine going, or something, you know, up with that carburetor, which I think it's the carb. It's just being a big pain in the butt. But yeah, everything worked out. The return line was working good. All that we fixed today was working. The lights still work. So I'm pretty happy with it. You can see lights are still working. So this thing came a long way from when I bought it. And it was a ton of work to get it to this point. But, you know, at least we got to ride it. So that's the video for today. Hope you guys enjoyed. Thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing. Stay tuned for next one. And until next time, we are out.